I know, but we have to do something.
Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The crooked man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place.
It's nothing. I'm fine.
I guess you've been worse. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily!
She was my sister!
How could you?
What do you have to say for
Where
yourself?
The fuck do you get
Those
off?
Poor girls.
You think you have the right
and
to just do
faith?
This to people? You're
done
a fucking
to
crook!
This? You should
fucking
be ashamed.
Shithole.
Everyone? Can I have your attention? Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder of Faith and...
As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Pordew who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie?
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Georgie paid for what he did. In the end, there was a fight, and he bled out from his wounds. It's over.
So he's dead? That's what you're saying?
I can't believe it was him.
So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
That doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I
don't...
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit! Like hell you
didn't. Stop the charade. We know you're an-
Everyone just shut up for a minute. You wanted a chance to talk. Well, go ahead.
What?
We all know he's guilty. What the fuck does he need to speak for?
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government, and most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to the witching
Where
ground.
It fucking belongs!
That's
so
right.
Let's get on
but
with
we
it
promised
then.
You a chance to defend yourself, and I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really
this
going to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Go ahead, Crooked Man.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, geez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
Tell
this is such bullshit.
You've always been a bit of a powder keg.
If you were so offended by it, why'd you cover it up then? If it had nothing to do with you and your shit, then why'd you try to protect him for so long?
What cover up? I never made any attempt to hide Georgie's criminal activity from you. I learned of it myself only recently.
For fuck's sake. Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
Yeah, and your goons attacked me. Did you forget that part?
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
Yeah, right. They don't do it because they want to protect you. You intimidate people. You scare tactics. They're afraid if they don't follow orders, they'll end up dead.
Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that, hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my better judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
you
in line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Crap, he's trying to worm his way into people.
Wasn't I?
We didn't abandon anyone. We've been trying to help them.
Really? What about Auntie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
She wanted my tree destroyed, but Bigby refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Don't blame Snow, she had her reasons. Greenleaf was using her magic to help Crane and the Crooked Man. That's why Snow wanted your tree burned.
That's not why.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with a Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away. But I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can.
We didn't get you into this situation. He did.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you. Exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help. And he would take that weakness and add it to his strength.
He took Faith and Lily from us. And while we can never get them back, we can certainly punish who's responsible.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over.
Yeah.
And those girls will have their justice.
Yeah. Go team.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you. Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's history.
What are you talking about?
And what about your history? all you've done to this fucking town.
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just need...
Of course it's right. This man tormented all of you, for profit. Georgie killed him.
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course. Where are you going with this?
If I'm to blame for Georgie's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Bluebeard.
It was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection.
Oh, I shouldn't have punched him. Is he gonna bring that up?
Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
crimes.
This
isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you. That's not
true. I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to...
To who?
This is how it's always been.
Yes. See, this is exactly to what I'm speaking. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the...
Bigby? Miss White?
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
one? What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Vivian killed herself back at the Pudding and Pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think I...
Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy? You're done talking, Crooked Man. You had your chance.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever, somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's
I assure
not good
you,
enough.
Maybe
there will be
has
more
point.
If he isn't
Hasn't
stopped.
Been enough
I
don't
get so we get rid of him. Danger.
We can send him
Everyone,
away.
Listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
This is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything.
What about Bigby?
What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
Oh, come on.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine.
Making me decide.
This isn't how
it's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff.
Rip his head off.
Teach him a fucking lesson.
No.
He has to die.
We can lock him
Just
away.
Just fucking get rid of
I
him.
I think we should lock him up.
Not this way.
Oh my god. Oh, my hand was off the keyboard. Don't throw him off the wall.
I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep. Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already.
We're locking him up. Justice, not vengeance.
You said you had a way to keep him from hurting people.
Wait, you can't
be serious.
What
he's done, you're just gonna put him in prison?
This isn't the way, Sheriff.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, there's a way.
Lock him up.
All right, do it.
Well, that was actually kind of a difficult decision, to be honest. Those choices were blank.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Oh, God. Is my game
glitch? You come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
Is my game glitch? Oh, come on. I went through this whole thing without it. Oh.
Expecting. Morning, crooked man.
He's got a sharp tongue. I thought it would be better for everyone if he parted with it.
Thanks, Greenleaf.
Let's just call it even.
Hey, Sheriff.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
This fucking line.
Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Okay. Yeah, I feel like my game might be broken. Cool. No. I gave them money. What?
I'm going! Jesus!
I thought I could help him.
We only have like 5 minutes.
They carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
Sorry about all this. I tried to help.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby. I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her?
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Bye, guys.
Hey, Bigby. Where's your friend, Colin? Where's a fucking pig?
How should I know?
Colin should have been on that.
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
Still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah, I guess I am.
Afraid to take it off?
It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith Lily and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then, Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place.
Marissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God.
What happened? Can you tell me anything else?
I don't know what happened. But that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? Lied. I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
So you think that makes it okay to lie?
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith. I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her.
You were trying to get my attention. So you started all this.
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
It's going to be different now, I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her, or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other, and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I go out there, and I do my job. I put my life on the line. I get shot at. I do what has to be done for them. But at the end of the day, I'm still the bad guy.
I know. But they'll come around. You'll see. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town. Finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was.
I'm pretty awesome, right?
From where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Wait.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I
replace me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Wait a second.
I'll see you around.
And that's the end, guys. I think Georgie deserved to die. Look at all this stuff, if you care. And Faith's dead, Georgie's dead. Thank you for watching. This has been my Wolf Among Us playthrough. If you enjoyed, continue the story and read fables. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe if you want to watch more, and next time, you'll be seeing me playing Batman the Telltale Game. Thank you all for watching.
Everyone, it's Rec here. Just got done besting the King of Atlantis himself. Check out Brawler on our Amazon page, which you can find on our About Us section of our YouTube channel.